Church of Rome, for the Reverend Priesthood and Diaconate in Christ, all clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord.
Спасибо. Thank you.
spływał błyszczą dla zwierzęty.
St. Paul to the Corinthians.
Let us be attentive.
Brothers and sisters, as I see it, God has put us apostles at the end of the line, like men doomed to die in the arena. We have become a spectacle to the universe, to angels and men alike. We are fools on Christ's account. Ah, but in Christ you are wise. We are the weak ones, you the strong. They honor you while they sneer at us. Up to this very hour, we go hungry and thirsty, poorly clad, roughly treated, wandering about the homeless. We work hard at manual labor. When we are insulted, we respond with a blessing. Persecution comes our way. We bear it patiently. We are slandered. And we tried conciliation. We have become the world's refuse, the scum of all. That is the present state of affairs. I am writing you in this way, not to shame you, but to admonish you as my beloved children. Granted, you have 10,000 guardians in Christ. You have only one father. It was I who begot you in Christ Jesus through my preaching of the gospel. I beg you then, be imitators of me.
Premudrist.
Čitanje z poslanja svetoga apostola Pavla do Korintijan. Bratja, meni bo tak zdajeća, što Bog postavil nas apostolju, ostanemi nemov preznačenih na stratu. Ne bo stali vidovišćem i svitovi i angelom i ljudjem. Mi nerozumni Hrista rade, mi že u Hristi rozumni, mi nemični, vi že micni, vi slavni, mi že bez česte. Do čeho času mi holodujemo i strahni i nahi, nas bijut i mi skepalimos. Ми трудимося, прочуючи власними руками, нас ображують, а ми благословляємо. Нас гонять, а ми терпимо. Нас ганблять, а ми з любові визіваємося. Ми бо в те сміття світу стали, покидки всіх аж досі. Не щоб осоромити вас, я це пишу, але щоб, як дітей моїх улюблених, навести на розум. Бо хоч би ми мали тисячі учителів у Христі, та батьків небагато. Бо я вас породив через Євангелію Христі Ісусі. Отож, благаю вас, будьте моїми послідовниками.
Верьте мне, премудрість, будьмо уважні.
Thank you.
he said, take pity on my son, who is demented and is in serious condition. For example, he often falls into the fire and frequently into the water. I brought him to your disciples, but they could not cure him. In reply, Jesus said, what an unbelieving and perverse lot you are. How long must I remain with you? How long can I endure you? Bring him here to me. Then Jesus reprimanded the demon, and it came out of the boy. That very moment, the boy was cured. The disciples approached Jesus at that point and asked him privately, why did we not expel it? Because you have so little faith. He told them, I assure you, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you will be able to say to the mountain, move from here to there, and it would move. Nothing would be impossible to you. This kind does not leave but by prayer and fasting. When they met again in Galilee, Jesus said to them, the Son of Man is going to be delivered into the hands of men who put him into death, and he will be raised up on the third day.
Glory be to you, Lord. Glory be to you.
Just kind of a few little short announcements. Actually really applies to the beautiful gospel today. This kind is only helped, when the disciples said, why couldn't we? He said, by prayer and fasting. And in Byzantine tradition, Eastern Rite Church, we have a more fasting than, in the Latin Rite, because, we have, of course, Lent, and we have, Advent before Christmas, but we also have over the cycle of the year, so I invite you, please read in the bulletin, the Dormition or Assumption fast that starts today, and it's only for a couple weeks, and really to prepare us for something so beautiful on August 15th, the Feast of Dormition. I mean, that's the Easter night, maybe, or Feast of Assumption. Really, so we do not jump to those major feasts without, of course, it's not as heavy as it is, with Lent. But again, so it will be your decision to really prepare yourself for this feast. So it starts today and on the Feast of the Assumption or Feast of Dormition, same name, same feast, different names. And really, so prayer, fasting, and then reception of the Holy Mystery. And then this week we'll have Divine Liturgy on Thursday, just regular Thursday. And then on Friday is the Feast of Transfiguration. So invite you, please come if you're able to. One of the 12 feasts, the Transfiguration, Divine Liturgy at 6 o'clock, at 9 a.m. And then there's a beautiful tradition, I grew up for the first 20 years in Poland, that so Slavs would actually do the blessings at the end of harvest. So we actually bless grapes and other fruits and vegetables. So you're more than welcome to bring your little baskets on the Feast of Transfiguration on this Friday. And then those who are not able to attend, more than welcome to bring them on Sunday, the following Sunday, for the blessing. And again, I think these are the only announcements. Visit the bulletin, visit the parish website. There's longer bulletin, there's always something interesting to learn and to educate yourself. In the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. If you have faith as a grain of a mustard seed, you will tell this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible to you. These are the words that Christ said to his disciples when they couldn't expel the demon from that boy. And they asked, why not? Because if you would go back in the gospel readings, you will find a place that Christ gave the authority to expel demons from the sick one. And now they couldn't. Could the Father first approach the disciple? And they couldn't. And then Christ says, this kind is really with prayer and fasting. So if you will have strong faith, stable faith, then nothing will be possible to you. In the Jewish tradition, there is a saying that, you know, mountain removers would be to those people who would be able to deal with the obstacles, who would be able to, you would come to the wise man, wise woman, and, you know, share with them your difficulty or your problem, and they would be able to help. So again, they would be called mountain removers. So Christ compares faith to a little tiny mustard seed. I'm sure if you've seen it, I don't think I did, but it's really, really small, one of the smallest seeds. But when it's planted, when it grows, it becomes a really quite big, little tree, bush tree, and a few, you know, tree with birds, and, you know, and they love it, but they make nests there. So a little tiny grows to a large bush tree. So the same thing really happens with our faith. If we have faith, and we take care of that faith, if we nurture our faith, then we'll become big faith, you know, and nothing will be really impossible to us. So it's really the question, what kind of faith do I have? Do I give up? Do I nurture my faith? Then Jesus said that this kind of demon is cast out by prayer and fasting. So like showing us the tools on how we can look after and strengthening our faith by praying more, or maybe perhaps praying differently. Faith is a gift granted to all of us by God. And as every gift, we need to nurture that gift so it will grow. Prayer and fast are important steps of strengthening our faith. So let's pay our attention on prayer. What does it really mean to us? What does it mean to pray? Is a prayer just when we come to church on Sunday or Saturday or during the week? When we sing together, you know, the prayers, and we sing Lord have mercy and so on, is that the only time we pray? Or is it when we are alone at home? When we stand in front of a figure or an icon, we say some words, some prayers, is that really a prayer? Or is it maybe when we do a good work among other people? Is that a prayer? Well, all of them are prayers. Every one of these is a prayer. But what place, what position does prayer take in our life? Look again, over the last few Sundays, you would refresh your, you know, you can go to our past bulletins on our website. You would hear the gospel that Jesus helped those who needed the help. He helped Peter, the apostles, you know, remember, you know, they were the storm, and they were afraid that they will drown. So he helped them. He healed a young man, a paralytic. He helped people who came to him. So when he sees people in need, he helps them. He always has time for every one of us. God always has time for you and me. And our prayer is that time which we have with God. So let's think now. God always has time for one of us. He always has time for me. So really, of course, the next part is, how much time do I have to spend with God? And as you would probably know, unsurprisingly, unfortunately, very often in our world, we have no time at all. We hear this phrase from many people, and we probably say it ourselves as well, I don't have enough time. We don't have enough time for anything. I don't have time even to rest. I don't have time to finish my work. I don't have time for spending with my friends or family. I don't have time as much as I wanted to spend the time with my children. And we can go on and on with the list. What about time for God? That we need to find 1 hour on Sunday to come to church. But it's supposed to be like that, just that, you know, out of guilt I have to go to church. It's a day of obligation. Is 1 hour a week enough to thank God for all that I have? I've been blessed with. Church teaches us about constant prayer, not morning prayer or evening prayer or being in church prayer. It does not mean that we need to be all day in church with a prayer book and praying. It means that all our thoughts need to be turned to God every moment of our life. When we say prayers, we speak with God. That is why we need to do it as often as we can. Not just on Sunday. Not just in the morning or in the evening before we go to bed. But every single moment that we have chance to do so. And also, when we work, when we, good to, when we do good deeds, when we have fun, when we rest, we could do it with a prayer or as a prayer. When we do it in the presence of God, He doesn't really prohibit each and every one of us from doing all those things. He wants us to rest. He wants us to have fun or to work, to do whatever we like to do. But He wants to do all these things with us, not alone. That's why when I bless the couple who is getting married, so I always remind them, it's not only two of you are leaving the church, three, you and God. So every time when we pray, when we do those things, there's no room for argument. A good friend of mine, he's a married priest, and he loved praying, and right now he's in Anglican eparchy, but he was in Toronto Diocese. He said, well, my wife, you know, kind of sort of upset me, you know, and there was something in mind, but you know, he had to do the prayer. So he prayed, and then he comes to the kitchen, he sees her, and then so how can I argue with her? I just prayed. So the whole thing was just gone. So when we do that prayer, suddenly issues that we had, there are no issues. Good God is part of that, and suddenly, wow, okay. So try to really to do everything you do with God beside you. They say that the prayer is a conversation with God. So it means that the more we talk to Him, the closer to Him we will be. God is our loving Father. Let us bring to mind our parents. How often we would like to speak to them, to be with them. Let us bring to mind our children. How often we would like to speak with them or to be with them. So if God is that figure, our loving Father, how often we want to speak with Him or just to be with Him. You are driving to work. Wow, why not have that image? Make the sign of the cross, Lord, be with me as I drive so no one, you know, so I have no accident and so on. You're starting the day of work, Lord, bless me, be with me as I make decision, I deal with people who might be challenging and so on. So invite God for every second of your life. Even as you go to bed, invite God to be with you so you have a peaceful night, so it's a refreshing night. So I would like to wish all of us to want to be with God, to use every chance to speak and to be with Him. I would like to wish that we never have too much prayer, because it's not never enough. I would like to wish to be closer to God every moment of our life, here on the earth, and then forever in heaven. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory be forever.
Let us all say with your own soul, whole mind, let us say,
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty Lord, and our Father, we pray you hear us and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, in the greatness of your compassion, we pray you hear us and have mercy.
Lord,
Духом і силою Твоєю, Духові, нині, во свят час, на віки вічні.
giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us stand well. Let us stand with fear and be affected. To offer in peace the holy oblation.
Mercy of peace, the sacrifice of praise.
Praise the Lord Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, the Father, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up our hearts.
Give them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord.
It is right and just to worship the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Trinity, one and being undivided.
Of your truth. And grant with one voice, one heart, and may glorify, sing the praises of your most honored, magnificent name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Amen.
In the mercy of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Having remembered all the saints again and again, please let us pray to the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Having God has received the spiritual triumphs upon his holy heavenly mystical altar, may send down on us in return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
Let him be delivered from all tribulation, wrath, and misfortune. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. Jesus, Christ, Lord, thine, our
inheritance.
Thank you.
Father, and the Son.